There are risks and there's noise. Help us differentiate the two. What are the risks and what's the noise?
Most of the things associated with Donald Trump is essentially noise. It's a transactional presidency. In other words, the fact that, as you correctly said, the fact that he pulls out of the court doesn't mean he pulls out. He could be back in, just like with NAFTA. So to me, a lot of that is noise. What is real, however, is U.S. dollar and U.S. dollar appreciation that we have experienced. Remember, only 2 months ago, every pundit, every commentator believed that U.S. dollar entered a long-term bear market trajectory, which is going to last for a long time. And suddenly, U.S. dollars reversed and started to appreciate considerably. We're already seeing stresses started to emerge, whether it's Argentina, whether it's Turkey, whether it's Indonesia.
Right.
So the question is, what drives U.S. dollar? How far is it going to go? How much stress there will be on liquidity flows, on commodity prices, on reflation, and on ability of countries to repay their debt. I think that is real. Everything else, to my view, is noise.
And what are you telling your clients now? Is this rally in the dollar, is this just short covering? Is it a sustained rally ahead? And if it does rally ahead, it rallies against what? Because these things trade in pairs.
Yeah, that's true. My concern is that U.S. dollar could get much, much stronger in the short term. And the reason for that is very simple. Supply of U.S. dollar is declining. Now, the reason for that, Federal Reserve is basically destroying liquidity. They are shrinking their balance sheet. When you shrink your balance sheet, you basically destroy the money that you have created. At the same time, the United States current account deficits are not rising in any considerable way. So the result is supply of US dollar is starting to contract. That's point number one. Point number two is that real spreads between US treasuries and German bunds and the Japanese government paper are pretty much at the highest level they've ever been. And the third point to remember, negative positioning against US dollar right now is pretty high. Some of it is getting reversed, but it's pretty high. So you can see how all of that, whether it's supplied U.S. dollar, whether it's spreads, whether it's positioning, how it all can reverse very, very quickly. Longer term, what supports U.S. dollar? It's its role as a global currency. I think all this discussion about renminbi, euro, yen, ruble is just nonsense. U.S. dollar is a global currency. It will remain a global currency. So that means that every time U.S. dollar goes up, you have a problem somewhere. U.S. might be okay, but everything else will not.